Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this channel. Hope you all are doing well at your home during this lockdown. Stay home, stay safe. I'm going to learn about how to draw screw conveyor on SolidWorks. There are two tricks to draw screw conveyor on SolidWorks. So today I am going to teach with first method, and second trick I am going to teach this on different video. So let's start. Click on file, select new, go to part and click OK. Here you are able to see the background, how to change background. Today we are going to learn little bit in a smooth way. In the last 2-3 videos I am doing little faster, that is not well for you all. So firstly, why I click here, you can see there apply scenes. Here the background, I just to change the background of this periphery of this drawing slide. I just want to change the background. You can, I generally go with the plain white, or you can go with any background you like to. If you want to go with this, or you want to go with this, or you want to go with rooftop, whatever you like, but I generally prefer plain white. And after drawing your objects on SolidWorks, even though you can change your background one at any time you want. Okay, select any plane. Then now I am selecting plane number front plane. Okay, go to a sketch, click circle. Okay, here draw a circle. Alright, while drawing, and give a dimension to this. Here I am giving a dimension to this is 10 mm. Now exit. Okay, then after go to feature, go to excluded boss. Are you able to see? Go to excluded boss and click this. All right you can see it is excluded in solid form. Generally the shaft we had in our real life is generally of solid, and I'm assuming that I have a solid shaft. I'm making it 500 mm long. All right I'm supposing I have a 500 mm long shaft. Okay, click OK. Here go to this plane, or you can go with this sketch. Okay, click here, bring to normal. All right go to sketch again, select circle, and go to with your pencil cursor, go on the circumference of the circle that you have drawn initially. Here you can see there is a, or here you can see while going to the circumference there is a black dot at the center of this circle. Go and click here and draw this circle. How much you have given, how much you have to give a dimension? The dimension you have to give is 10 mm of same. All right have you given this? Now go to feature, go to curve helix. Yes. Okay, here you can define by, there is a 4 option given. If you remember in a coil spring I have mentioned this all 4: pitch and revolution, height and revolution, height and pitch, and a spiral. Go with the height and pitch. Height we have a 500. All right and how much pitch you have to give? You have to give 100 pitch. Here you can see the curve have been generated opposite direction. For this, go here and click reverse direction. Now you can see in a yellow line, this is the what, but I want to reduce its pitch. I will go with 75. All right, now let us see how it's look. Okay, it look less still nice. If I will reduce it to 50, let us see. Okay, here it look nice. I think here start angle will be the same. There will be no this variable pitch, but I will teach you about this, that how variable pitch works in our next video whenever I will bring it. Click OK. All right, you have this all. Now how you have to make a profile of that screw conveyor, how it will go. If you remember, in a coil spring I teaches how to make a profile. Firstly, you have to create a plane. Plane for what? Where you are going to draw such profile. Like for a coil spring, you have drawn circular. Here you have to draw a seat for it. Okay, now go to here plane. If you remember, here I want to go with this. Have you remember? And second reference I want to give is this point. Hope you have seen there is a plane around it, and here a message have already been delivered that it is fully defined. Now go to this plane and go to sketch. All right, go to align. Okay, or you can directly go with corner rectangle. Click here, draw. I will give a dimension over here. How much it needed? I think I will give it 3 mm of seat. Sorry, here you have to mention how long it should be. I will give 50 mm of the length, and I will provide its thickness. Actually, you are giving thickness of this. What you are providing? Thickness of the seat. I will give, generally we have a 3 mm of thickness of the seat. And now exit. Okay, after exiting, you must have to use feature. Which feature? Which one of the features? Shift boss base. This feature you are going to use as similar as while drawing a spring coil in the last video. All right, for this you need to select this. All right, it have sometime it select automatically. This is the sketch we have drawn just now. We want to give this profile we have, and second we'll give a path. Which path? This one. You can see that we have already generated a screw conveyor on your screen. Click OK. All right, here is your spring. Here is your conveyor, screw conveyor. As similar in the method here we have applied as similar as coil spring. Okay, now I will change, I will hide this plane. Okay, I will hide, I will hide this spiral. Now I will change the reference. I will change its color. I will go with yellow. Okay, click OK. Here is your conveyor, screw conveyor. This is the first trick how we can draw a conveyor. Okay, conveyor on SolidWorks. It is similar as how you draw coil spring on SolidWorks. Just you have to mention a profile and you can draw it with a shaft and screw. Thank you so much for this. Hope you will be okay at your home. Stay home, stay safe at your home during this lockdown. And thank you so much for watching this video.